Let's celebrate. There's a party going on right here. A celebration to last throughout the years. So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on now. Let's all celebrate and have a good time.
Celebration.
We gon' celebrate and have a good time. It's time to come together. It's up to you. What's your pleasure?
Okay, from the foyer of the East LA College Auditorium, Mr. David Loera, and it's our pleasure to meet and greet you, sir. Tell us about what happened here with the Hall of Fame induction today.
Well, we try to revise the Hall of Fame induction, and I became chairman of the committee, and the last one we had was in 1984,
Okay. And
so we had to get everything together and it took me about a year to get everything and do this. A look at the campus news to get articles and think of people that we wanted to induct, and then we went from there. Okay.
And this was a sports specific, it was track and field, is it correct?
Track and field, yes.
Okay, and there was a big lineup of outstanding All-Americans from ELAC and All-State and just all kinds of very, very important athletes that have made their mark here through East LA College.
Yes, we had several, as you can see, there's a sign behind me with the All-Americans, which is first through fourth place in the state of California championships, and the state champions, and the history of the coaches. And the most important thing is that we haven't seen each other for about 40 years, okay. So we did a great job.
Okay, and this is going to be a trend. Would you say that there's also a committee for other sports that's going to be building and looking to set their sights on honoring those athletes that played here at East LA College?
Yes. Based on what we did today, it'll be every other year, and it'll be here, and we'll make sure we get it out to the media and everything else.
Okay, Dave, you got to be very happy because you're able to acknowledge not only the athletes of that generation, but also their families that were here. And just give a name of the few of the athletes that were here that were honored tonight.
Okay, we had the 1968 state championship team with Steve Lang, Danny Moore, Chris Watkins, myself. We also had James Butts, who was a silver medalist in the Olympics, the 76 Olympics. We had David Gillard, who was a state champion. We had Bobby Almanzo, who was a state champion on the relay with James Bates, one of our inductees. Sure. We had Floyd Jeter, who was the first double champion, 53 and 54 in a high jump, who ended up on the Olympic team, and several other athletes.
Sylvia Mosqueda also?
Sylvia Mosqueda, the queen. Yes. 5 Olympic trials. She's 47 and she's still running like crazy. And she's from Las Vegas now, and she has a club there, and you can see her on CoachSylviaMosqueda.com.
Okay, David Leto, thank you very much for giving us this opportunity to speak with you and give us a description of what happened tonight. Good luck to you and the next Hall of Fame induction as well.
Okay, thank you. Go Huskies.
All right, Huskies. All right, we're going to be back now with Jacqueline Seabrook, the Chief of Police for Santa Monica Police Department. We'll be right back with East LA Sports Scene. And continuing on with our keynote speaker tonight, because she is an East LA College alumni, Huskie herself, ran for the track team here, and it is Chief of Police Jacqueline Seabrooks. And Jacqueline, how are you doing tonight here on a big night of induction here for East LA College track and field team?
I'm doing very well, and it's wonderful to be a part of this wonderful celebration of these storied athletes. Even as a former Huskie, still Huskie at heart, it was gratifying to see just how many people had come before, and the history wasn't well known. I was very surprised to see at how many Olympic athletes we have, how many people had gone on to do coaching and do some wonderful things after their track and field experiences here at East LA College.
And it seems a big sense of family continues to this day.
Oh, absolutely. And then even with some of the people that I just met this evening, we know people in common. I've heard of them. So it was just like walking into the family reunion.
Okay. Now, you gave a very good story when you were giving your remarks. And again, education was a big difference here in your life, because you learned about the law enforcement career and off you went. So that has to be very, very motivating to you, and still to this day, fulfilling.
Absolutely. I mean, I look at the phrase scholar athlete, and coming here to East LA College was the beginning of my scholar athleticism. I came here because I'd heard that the criminal justice department was very good, and I was applying for my first police job.
Okay.
I received that job after my first track season here, where I was able to place fourth in the state in the 800 meters,
yes.
Win the conference championships in the 400 meter hurdles, the 800 meters, and to be a part of an award-winning 4x400 relay team. So I really think, you know, at the end of the day, it set the tone for where I am today.
And again, as we all know, those of us that have been through the athletic training and chose a sport that we loved and had passion for, you can always look back on it and spread that same affection to those in your family or to those that you're mentoring, to our youth. Especially. Can you talk a little bit about how you might give back on your spare time?
Well, of course. Well, we have a police activities league in Santa Monica, and what we do is we participate in Students Run LA. That's the program where we work with young people to run the Los Angeles Marathon. And because of the affinity that I have for running that developed, quite frankly, here at East LA College, I've run the Los Angeles Marathon 5 times with young people, and it's an opportunity for police officers, myself and others, to engage young people in a way that helps them to participate in a culture of fitness, but at the same time we can message about the importance of academics and also talk about what it's like to be a young person coming up today.
Okay, and the opportunity is also for career mentorship or career paths.
Of course.
Because this is a very, very important field to get into, and it's a very one that's, of course, very, very necessary.
Absolutely.
In our lives today as we speak. So the opportunities to gain a career advantage, or it seems like they're right there for those that want to take that particular profession up.
That's absolutely correct. I mean, anything we can do to promote a culture of fitness, anything that we can do to promote a culture of academics and scholarliness in our young people is crucial. And then anything that we can do, taking into consideration those two things, that helps to put them on the pathway to college and put them on the pathway to a profession, I think is important. And whatever I can do my part. I'm glad to do it.
And we're speaking to, of course, Chief of Police Jacqueline Seabrooks, and again, always very, very forthcoming. We watched your career continue to grow here locally as news watchers and, of course, our community watchers, and just doing things in law enforcement at a very high level. We commend you for that.
Well, thank you very much, and I have to say thank you, East LA College. Once a Huskie, always a Huskie.
Okay, there you have it. Okay, woof. Thank you. Thank you. Chief of Police Jacqueline Seabrooks, and we wish her well on her continued success as the Chief of Police for the Santa Monica Police Department. We'll be right back with more of East LA Sports Scene. Okay, speaking with one of the inductees, Sylvia Mosqueda, and she is a world-renowned athlete and very proud of her heritage and very proud of what she did here at East LA College. Sylvia, ¿cómo estás?
Estoy bien, gracias. I just want to thank East LA for having this great Hall of Fame induction. I never thought that it would be done. It's been very many, many, many years. Mm-hmm. And thanks to Coach Loera that I remember him years ago mentioning that he wanted to get this induction going. And and I thought, when are you going to induct me when I'm 90? I mean, look at some people passed away, right?
Exactly.
So, you know, it was really awesome that he kept pushing, you know, to get this to happen. And it happened. And it's a great honor to me. I mean, running has done so much for me. Mm-hmm. It has me travel the world. I met fantastic people, great experience. Now I'm coaching, okay. And I have you know, Greg Ryan to thank for that. I had two other amazing coaches, which was Dick Brown from Eugene, Oregon, and I had Jim McClatchy from Bend, Oregon. Mm-hmm. And I've been with him for 12 years.
Okay.
And he's the coach that I lasted the longest with, and just really, really fed me amazing knowledge in the sport. And it's just now I'm 47, and I'm able to give back to the sport. And it's a blessing. And you know, I really didn't, I forgot to thank one person, and the main person is the Lord. And, and God has been very, very good to me, and I've been blessed by him.
Sylvia, as a youngster, just at that high school age, and then all of a sudden transitioning into going to college and growing up and maturing, look back on that for a moment and tell our viewers what coming to East LA meant to you at that time, because this was home, and then it was a starting point or the trampoline to get your career really going. Talk about East LA College.
Let me talk a little bit about East LA College. When I first had left San Gabriel High School, I didn't have any direction where I wanted to go, what I wanted to do. I got all these scholarships offered to me, and I was just, I completely just said, I'm not going anywhere.
Okay.
Where is running going to really take me,
yeah.
I thought at the time. And well, it was going to give me education, but back then being young, I didn't really see that. So Greg Ryan from East Los Angeles College kept knocking at my door, and that was a blessing because East LA has opened so many doors, and it's going to open many doors for a lot of these young athletes now. I really hope that this young lady is able to give it a shot and break my record. I mean, it's due. It's time.
Yes.
So, you know, it's important for the Latin community. It's important for all youngsters to really take in mind that school is very important, and East Los Angeles was a huge part of what I am today. And you know, I had great teachers, I had great role models, I had a phenomenal coach, and I have to give all the thanks to him and the Lord, yes.
And Sylvia, we acknowledge you because many of your records at the NC2A level still stand to this very day.
Division One.
Yes, Division One, and we also know of the marathon where you came out of nowhere.
19 years old, yes.
Who is this lady? Sylvia Mosqueda, you shocked.
I was a bandit, I didn't have a number. And then I came back in 87, and I took second, and I said, I'll never want to do a marathon again.
Yes.
And then I just, you know, kept bumping into phenomenal coaches, and they said, you know what, you're a lady that can run fast and long, so I give it another shot. Went to a couple Olympic trials. My event was a 10,000 meter on the track.
Yes.
Missed making the team in 92. I was fourth, but I never gave up.
Yes.
I went for the next one and the next one and the next one, and that's what all these young Latin people just have to know, that there is something out there for them, and they really need to acknowledge and really use school and not take it for granted. Don't take the education for granted. Use it properly.
words of wisdom. And Sylvia, because we know you have to get back to Las Vegas, unfortunately, we can't keep you here for another 20 minutes, but please leave our viewers with the capabilities of knowing how to see you, follow you online, because we understand you have a website.
Yes, I have a website, and it's CoachSylviaMosqueda.com, and I do online coaching, and I now I'm in Las Vegas giving back to the sport still, and a lot of these people are not as fast as people from Los Angeles. Los Angeles runners are phenomenal. These are people that are more sort of were like joggers, and now they're running fast, and I'm still doing what I love to do, and I'm not going to stop. It's just being a coach is like being an athlete still, watching my runners cross the line and seeing that smile on their face. It's phenomenal.
Yeah. A sense of accomplishment and victory, and also sometimes you have to go through the trials and tribulations to get better, but they can do that once they see where their charts are going to take them, what direction they want to go, and they can also find you to give them that guidance.
Yes, they can. So, okay, like I said, Sylvia Mosqueda, CoachSylviaMosqueda.com. You know, I design running programs and do coaching online.
La Reina de East LA College is the runner, the queen. Okay, Sylvia.
Muchas gracias. Okay. Trae buena noche.
Okay, we're going to come right back with more of East LA Sports Scene. Don't go away. And next up is one of the main inductees for tonight, Floyd Jeter, and you have a story that has not been told. We're going to try and become that link for you to get it told even further. But Floyd, congratulations, number one, on being inducted tonight.
Well, thank you very much.
East LA College, we've flipped the time machine backwards.
Yes, you did.
And
yes.
This has brought out a lot of emotion, a lot of good feeling, and some deep, deep good memories. Tell us how you feel right now.
Well, it's wonderful. First of all, I thank God that I'm still alive. Okay. I graduated from East LA 60 years ago.
Yes.
You know, I mean, I'm just wondering how I could still be here. And I mean, there's so many of my classmates that are no longer with us. And it's such a pleasure to come back and to recognize that we laid the foundation for everything that happened after us. That stadium was built in 1951.
Yeah.
I graduated from high school in 1952. We became a powerhouse by 1954. East LA track and field, we were monsters.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we had guys from Jefferson High School, Fremont High School, Manual Arts. We all came together. And at that particular time, the team to beat was Compton College.
Okay.
All these guys that ran internationally, once they got out of the service, whether it be the Air Force, Navy, or whatever, they would go to Compton College. They had like a free ride or something would happen. East LA, we beat them by 1 point. The coach could not believe, who are these guys? There's no way that you could beat us. He was out there in the dark re-adding it up. He still lost by 1 point. So I was so proud to be part of that team. I've always been a member of a team. Individually, when I do well, and we score points, and we all have our camaraderie, we get together. That's what it's all about. Individually, you know, thank you very much for the accolades, but at the same time, I'm just a team member.
Okay.
And that's
things that were very, very prominent in your story, at least when you were inducted and you had your remarks. Number one, let's talk about Boyle Heights, Roosevelt High School. You're a Rider for life, coming from Rider Nation, and then also your matriculation into University of Southern California as one of the first African Americans offered a scholarship. Let's talk about first your Boyle Heights and Roosevelt High School days.
Okay, I mean, as far as track and field is concerned, I achieved. I was well. I broke the league record in the high jump at the fastest time my senior year. For up until the very last meet, I ran a 14.8, which was very good at that time. But my claim to fame is, after 50 years, no one had done anything for my class of 52 to have a reunion.
Mm.
And I'm living, I live in San Luis Obispo, California, okay. So I don't live locally.
Yeah.
So I came down and said, is anybody going to do anything? So we have the principal who's with us, Henry Ronquillo,
okay,
who also graduated from East LA. And anyway, he was the principal, and he had 15 addresses, okay, of people from the class of 52.
Yeah.
Then I got together with Doofy Gutierrez. I don't know if you know Doofy.
No.
But Doofy was the first Mexican-American to be a member of the Rose Bowl committee in choosing the queen and all that good stuff.
Okay.
He had a few addresses. I started doing this and only had 2.5 months, but in 2.5 months' time, I was able to get 150 people from my graduating class. That was 50 years after I graduated. We've now had 12 successful picnics. We did it in the form of a picnic.
Good, good.
So we've gotten class of 52, 53, 54, and 55 to now co-host an annual gathering.
Okay.
This particular, by the way, we do this at the Oak Tree in Arcadia.
Okay.
And this year's date will be June the 18th.
Okay. And wrapping things up here with going to SC, that had to be one of the biggest accomplishments of your young career at that time.
Well, absolutely. I'll tell you what happened. Coach Clintzos, my high school coach, told me, I'm going to get you a scholarship to SC. I didn't believe him because, by the way, they gave one scholarship the year before to a black athlete. His name was Addison Hawthorne. He went to Pasadena College. Pasadena College was undefeated. This guy was like the original O.J. Simpson.
Okay.
SC gave him a scholarship. You know why? So he wouldn't go to UCLA. They set him on the bench and he didn't play him.
Oh, wow.
So
okay.
I'm thinking, coach, I took my classes for UCLA. But when it was time to graduate, the coach comes over and say, are you ready?
Okay.
And I say, coach, I took classes for UCLA. He said, I told you I was going to get you a scholarship.
Oh, wow.
So anyway, I had to spend an extra semester here. I took 19 units of solids.
Okay.
And then I went to SC
on
the scholarship.
Okay.
Yeah.
Final thoughts here on a big night. Okay.
Well, it's wonderful. First of all, to be with my family, a small part of my family. This is my son here, Floyd Jeter III. And he's with his two of his lovely daughters and my daughter-in-law.
Okay.
It's a pleasure. I got my girlfriend here.
Okay. Wonderful.
And she's been practicing saying Julie Jeter, so we'll have to see where that goes.
Okay.
And
all right. Floyd Jeter, 52-53, East LA Husky for life. We want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to talk to you.
Thank you.
Okay. Good luck to you. All right. We're going to come back with our final interview here in a moment. Don't go away. East LA Sports Scene here from the Hall of Fame induction, East LA College. We'll be right back. Speaking now with Coach Rick Gambo, no stranger to East LA sports scene. Coach, it's been a while, but it's good to see you again.
Wonderful.
And your involvement here at East LA College, and let's kind of bring our viewers up to speed as to how you've been doing and what you're currently involved in.
Well, I'm still teaching here.
Okay.
Really supportive of the athletic program. Our department is going from a PE department to a kinesiology department, so a lot more classroom teaching.
Yes.
Took a couple of years off for a hiatus, had knee surgery, and the old age, it's kind of creeping in. Decided to be a roadie for my son, who's only 16, and decided to miss coaching and wanted to go back into it.
All right.
So I'm going to go back to Pasadena City College.
Okay.
A good friend of mine is a head coach, and we hopefully could rebuild that program.
Okay.
The current coach here at East LA is Steve Maharo, who's doing a fabulous job.
Mm-hmm.
Hardworking, good recruiter, and really takes care of his young people.
Okay.
So we're excited about him.
And tie everything together to tonight here at East LA College at the auditorium here in the Hall of Fame induction.
Yes, it was. You know, and we got a small committee going, and what we're trying to do is resurrect the Hall of Fame here at East LA. Recognize the athletes from the various sports, both men and women, bringing them back, recognizing them, and then really trying to get the community to realize we got some wonderful student athletes who came here, went on to much bigger and better things, and just like we had the police chief for the Santa Monica Police Department coming in, great athlete here, and came back to visit and share some words, and I think that's what we will need is we have such a wonderful community college that had so many people from the community come in, get their start.
Yes.
It's the stepping stone to much bigger things, and they've gone on. Lee Baca, Ben Davidson, Clarence Davis.
Absolutely.
So we're really fortunate to have a great institution.
Okay.
We have a great family, and we're trying to, with resurrecting the Hall of Fame, we hope to bring some of these great family members back.
And Coach, let's talk about the specifics of to be by sport categories.
I think we are. We're formulating larger committees.
Okay.
We're trying to get some of the alumni to come back in, and besides just the local coaches.
Okay.
And for example, this coming fall, 2014, we're going to have a reunion from the 1974 state championship team.
Okay.
We're going to recognize them at one of the home games, and from that, to be able to get some inductees,
all right,
and then have a big event for all the various sports,
okay,
both men and women, for spring of 2015.
Okay.
A similar event like this, yeah, but recognizing the various sports.
Okay, Coach Rick Campbell.
We're really happy.
Thank you so much. You
it's been a long time. It's wonderful to see you.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Coach. All
appreciate
right, there
it.
He is, Coach Rick Campbell. We're going to come back with our final interview in just a moment. This is East LA Sports Scene. And speaking with James Butts, he was inducted into the East LA College Track and Field Hall of Fame. And James, congratulations, because you carry the green and white very, very proudly all the way through your life situation as we speak. And it was a great opportunity to get to know you a little more personal tonight. But talk about your thoughts and feelings right now at this moment that you have been inducted.
It's a very powerful feeling to be part of the ELAC family. When we started back in the day, we had a real sense of everybody wanted to do well here, okay? By doing that, we motivated others, okay? To come together today to celebrate the fruits of our labor is a very wonderful thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm honored. I feel that I have so much still to give.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still helping others. And this is a good launching pad for anybody to be here to feel the flavor of this.
Yes.
We're here to do excellence. And ELAC has always been that way.
Yes.
And this is one of the big reasons I came here, along with my classmates and myself. And we wanted to do outstanding things, win state, win titles, and also go to Olympics.
And personally, you're a member of at least three Olympic teams, right?
Yes. I made three Olympics. I was alternate in 1972, made the one in 76. I was alternate in 1980.
Okay. And in the field event it was?
What's that again?
The field event, your event of choice was?
The triple jump.
Oh, the triple jump,
yes.
Which is, again, we're not hearing so much about athletes that have stepped up in a bigger fashion in the triple jump. There's been a few, but hopefully there's more to come.
Well, I dominated for the event for 10 years,
mm-hmm,
and nobody really stayed to look at it until I started jumping.
Okay.
They would always put you with the mile relay, and after that, people were leaving.
Mm.
All of a sudden, when you break an American record, people start taking notice.
Yes.
And then you're just falling a couple inches short of the world record, they really notice.
Mm-hmm.
One of my colleagues that I trained, he eventually broke the world record. So the notoriety is there now, and I feel I'm happy that I was able to help in some
and
small way.
Pick up the trail, your educational path and career from East LA College. You went out to a Division I school.
Yes, so at UCLA, I earned my degree in sociology. I have a minor in meteorology.
Mm-hmm.
I'm currently working as a peace officer for the City of LA, the Department of Water and Power.
Okay.
And it's been a very wonderful ride so far, and I'm just really blessed.
And it was very, very, very nice, and as they say, a good feeling, a warm feeling to see your old buddies, your old teammates from the past.
From junior high school to right now, I'm glad we're all still here. The Lord has blessed us to be here another day, and we just look forward to the next challenge, whatever that may be. I know we'll do the best we can.
Well, I know it's going to make you really, when you get home, and I maybe talked a little bit more about what was spoken about tonight. I mean, what I remember was your story about going in the Volkswagen and then in the other vehicle over to the all-comers meet over in Pierce College. That had to be such a very profound experience for you as a youngster growing up.
It's humbling, but you have to get to point A to point B somehow.
Yes.
And that was the way we did it. We're very humbled to be able to participate in those events under those conditions, and winning was the fruits of that sacrifice. It's just great that we're here now. We're adults, we're parents, we're grandparents,
yeah,
and we can say, wow, we did add something to the greatness of the school.
And, of course, finally blessed to be able to be here with all your old colleagues and teammates and some new friends here that you met tonight.
Definitely. And I'll be with me my whole life. And I look forward to future gatherings like this to motivate our younger people who are coming up to take our place.
Okay.
Let them know that there's shoes to fill and they're there for you to get in them. And if you can do it ELAC style, ELAC's the place to be.
Once a Huskie?
Always a Huskie.
All right, there he is, James Butts. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
Right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, that'll do it. That's going to wrap up our track and field Hall of Fame induction tonight here from the campus of East LA College, right in the foyer of the main auditorium. So for Eric Sonny, Rico Cabrera, thanks for watching, and continue to watch East LA Sports Scene for new and exciting content. We'll see you on our next show.